Have you seen people that have swollen legs like this? Any person you see with a swollen leg, two things, lead poison. Two things will be responsible majorly. It's either that the person has a heart-related problem or the kidney is not working. One is that the heart is not pumping blood as it's supposed to pump, or that the kidney is not excreting the water as it's supposed to excrete. So the water will be get trapped in the body. Are you with me? And sometimes you may see people that their own may be a little different. This particular one is as a result of blockage of the lymphatic channel. And if you press this one, it doesn't go inside. This could be what is called filariasis or elephantiasis. It's a different ball game. Somebody's leg could also swell if this very person is not eating well, like in case of Kwachioko, or somebody that is chronically ill is not eating well because of lack of protein. It will now be the leg will start swollen. You may see some of them, the tummy will be swollen, filled up with water, what is called ascites. This thing can happen, and in most cases, you can have what is called easy fatigability. Somebody you know, you see what I'm talking now is so practical. Somebody you know that used to be very, very active, all of a sudden, you see that if this person climbs staircase, it will be panting. He says, I say, what's going on? The heart is not performing well. The heart, when it is loaded, just like a generator that is old, when the turbo charger cannot power a big place, if he give you load, it will be smoking and telling you, I am dying. Majority of our people's heart is already gone. It has not. But they are managing it like that, but painfully. Among God children, as it were, we'll be told, it is an enemy. Is responsible. For how long can we continue to receive such a devilish lie? Anyone that tells you don't go to hospital, if you go to hospital, you will die. Ask the person, is that devil in the hospital? No. That's why I say, if you know what I know today, honestly, if you know, you will be more furious to say we can't continue to allow our people to be dying and nobody seeing anything. People will just walk, slump and die, sleep without waking up. As everybody say, no, don't talk. Don't say anything. No, ignorance and darkness can prevail over light. Check out. Can you look at the life expectancy of other nations? Hong Kong, 85 years. Look at even Ghana, 64. All the Northern Africans average of 73 years. Nigerian life expectancy is 54 years. Did you know why COVID-19 killed more Americans, more Europeans? He said in Italy, he killed so many people. If you get to Italy, 22.8% of Italians are above 65 years. Above 65 years, meaning that they have older people. That's why COVID-19 killed most of them. Our own, it don't kill us because most of us are so young. The older ones are no more. We can't continue like this. And somebody will be saying, no, it's an attack. If it's the demon and all those things we're praying, look at this. Look at this life expectancy. How can you compare this and the Nigerians that are praying 24/7? Doing all manner of spiritual exercise 24/7. The time has come for us to know. Now we tell you again, why is it that sometimes they will tell you that their heart is enlarged? What could make the heart enlarged? Yes, the heart can enlarge. You know, for anything to be bigger in size, it means that it contains more volume. Just like a gallon, if you fill the gallon, it will get bigger. So when there be excess fluid in the heart, as a result of maybe the heart is not pumping out water, as the fluid or the blood as it's supposed, what will happen if the heart pumps out less blood? Because it's weak to pump out, when the blood that is not enough comes to the kidney will say, oh, it's like when they set up dehydration and we trigger a particular hormone that is called antidiuretic hormone. What it does is that it will reabsorb all the water back. So thinking that because the water is not enough, so more water will be accumulating in the heart, and also you see all those swelling also continue. So that's why you see they say that the heart is enlarged. But see, one of the things I want to show you, very, very striking. Some people will sleep, and when they wake up deep in the sleep, they will be panting, and it will be as if, honestly, that attack came at the depth in the night. You know why? See what happened? When somebody is standing up, the fluid in the body may go down the legs, all right? Like that one we see. You see, the leg will just be pitting. If you touch it, it will go inside and come out, all right? Now, when this very fellow is sleeping and is lying down this way, okay? Now, see what happens here? That very fluid that used to be, you know, go to the dependent area, will now begin to flow inside the lungs because the person is lying flat. And because this fellow will be deep asleep, see why when they are waking up, they wake up as if it's an attack. I will tell you. Because at this point, the water is flowing into the lungs. This is supposed to trigger somebody, just for somebody who is drowning inside. So, but because when you are sleeping, the respiratory center in the brain will be calm. It will not be able to trigger that effect. So, while this person is sleeping, even when water is covering it, he may not feel it initially. Alright? Secondly, if you're under anxiety, that's what is called catecholamine, a chemical messenger, it makes your heart to beat faster. But because when you are sleeping, those chemical messengers will not be released, and the heart will not be responsive as it were. So, as this person is sleeping, and the water will be accumulating, by the time the water is there, as if somebody sleeping in the house, and water is the flood is covering the place, and he suddenly wake up. Hey! And at that point, he wakes up. He will not breathing fast. So we rush to the window to go and see whether we get fresh air. And by the time he stands for a while, about 5 minutes, that water can now come down towards the base of the lungs. So he can now feel better. If he tells me, sir, I'm feeling better now. I'm feeling better now. I'm feeling better now. I'm feeling better now. That is what is called paradoxinal nocturnal dyspnea. It's a very big grammar. All these are signs of heart failure. Sometimes the person may be coughing, and that very cough, productive of just putting that as if there are bubbles in it. All these things happen. It is no spirit that could be responsible. And do you know the good news? This thing can be treated. NICE Guideline UK in 2018 gave a practical treatment of it that has to do with the drugs, and also that has to do in a situation the drugs is not helping this other person. It can be in position to do what a cath lab can be in position to offer. It is called biventricular pacemaker. This pacemaker will help when it's connected to the heart. It will help the heart to be in position to be working. And this person can be productive again. This person can live for the children and be able to support also the economy of the nation. A lot of people are suffering this as I'm talking. But what is the issue? They can't go to hospital because they know what is responsible for their problem. Who is he? One person orchestrated to be an enemy. Can you imagine this? That is why we are saying enough of this untimely death. Enough of us recording a life expectancy of 54 years and somebody is saying you still have to talk about it. People will sleep and will not wake up. People will walk away from what the activities are doing and the person will not come back again. And somebody says, so allow it. It is prophetic. Which kind of prophecy? Prophecy of God that the Bible says, I will satisfy you with long life. Anything contrary to that, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. But he said, true knowledge shall the just one be delivered. The real prayer, let this knowledge today deliver you from whatever is causing your problem. Share this to everyone you know. Please, share to your loved one. As I'm talking right now, somebody is suffering. Why not share? By so doing, we can build a healthy society. I remain your friend, Dr. Richard Okoye. See you again.